This is a monarch butterfly. Monarch butterflies in our household are very special, not only because they're beautiful and important pollinators, but because the very first monarch butterfly we ever hatched was hatched the morning that my son was born. And since then, we've had at least one monarch butterfly hatch on his birthday every single year. About a year ago, I made a video on how you can hatch monarch butterflies at home. And that's a really important thing to do for their populations, because when we bring them inside and give them shelter, we increase their chance of surviving into adulthood from about 3% to over 90%. So if you want to check out that video, please do so below. By far, it's my channel's most popular video, and I really appreciate all the views and all the love that it's received. This video today is actually in response to some of the comments that video has received, asking for a little more detail on exactly what my indoor setup looks like. So today I'm going to try to give you any little tips that I can think of on how to successfully have little guys like this join the planet.
Before I bring any caterpillars inside, I have to find the eggs or tiny caterpillars on the leaves. I have two kinds of milkweed in my garden, and butterflies seem to prefer laying their eggs in different parts of each of them.
So I have right here swamp milkweed and common milkweed. On my common milkweed, I've only ever found eggs on the underside of the leaves, but it can be anywhere, on the top, on the bottom, or even on the seed pods of my swamp milkweed over here. The butterfly doesn't mind. So when I come over to my swamp milkweed and I want to look for eggs, I tend to go down low a little bit and I'm casting my eye everywhere. What I'm looking for is not just any kind of bump, but that sort of raised slight oval with the mini stripes in the texture.
Some other eggs that I found on milkweed are different from monarch eggs in that they're clustered together, smaller and rounder, or a different color. This is what a monarch egg will look like, regardless of the type of milkweed. An ivory textured oval that comes to a gentle point. As the caterpillar inside the egg matures, you will be able to see the dark caterpillar through the translucent shell.
I'm going to bring this egg inside so that a predator doesn't get it before it hatches, but I'm also going to store it in a container with a milkweed leaf, so when it does hatch, it has easy access to its first food.
Also, to keep humidity relatively high but not cut off airflow, I loosely place a lid on my containers with leaves and eggs. I use clear lids or clear containers. I have used opaque ones before, but I found that the less visible the caterpillars, the less attentive I am to changing their leaves. Then I keep the containers in a highly visible place, but out of direct sunlight so they don't turn into mini greenhouses. My preference is to keep smaller caterpillars and eggs in shallow, flat containers, and then to move larger caterpillars into taller jars with a wide mouth. Monarch caterpillars will want to climb and hang from something when they reach their final instar, so I put a small sturdy twig into the loosely covered jar once the caterpillar is a few centimeters long, around the fourth or fifth instar. There are five stages of development of the caterpillars called instars. In between them, the caterpillar will shed its exoskeleton. I usually don't keep caterpillars of different sizes in the same jar or container in case a bigger one thinks that a smaller one looks like a good snack. Once they're big enough for the taller jars, I try to put only one in each jar. Occasionally, I will have a caterpillar create its chrysalis in a non-ideal place, like on a leaf that's going to collapse or a jar that really needs to be cleaned, and I'll want to move it. The key to moving a set chrysalis is to change where the silks that are coming out of the chrysalis are anchored. If you look closely, you will see a fine web of silks spiraling out of the top of a chrysalis. I find a narrow or pointy stick, like a kebab stick, is a really great tool to gently get under those silks. Start a few inches or further away from the chrysalis and come forward. You'll start to get under the edge, and as you get closer, you'll see more and more silks appear to be over your kebab stick. Then, as I gently loosen the silks, I spin the kebab stick so that the silks get stuck around it until it feels secure. I can then balance the kebab stick and the chrysalis in a better spot until the butterfly hatches. It can help if you first practice with an empty chrysalis shell. Once the butterfly hatches, you have a little time before you need to move it outside. We'll wait, depending on the weather or the time of day, until there's a best time for the butterfly to start flying. But if they start trying to fly while they're in the jar, even if it's nighttime or maybe stormy outside, we will bring it outside to a sheltered location and open the jar so it can choose if it wants to stay inside there or to venture out, and it doesn't hurt itself trying to escape. When the weather's good or it's a good time of day, we will often suspend the butterflies outside out of direct sunlight so that they can fully unfold and then just take off whenever they like.
This butterfly is probably getting pretty close to ready to fly away. It's been hanging out with us for 10 hours or so. Often after they hatch, if it's very humid out, they'll stay close to the house or in the garden for quite some time, and then eventually they'll run off into the great big world. So if you notice butterflies doing that, it seems like they've hatched and then they're not doing anything for even up to 2 or 3 days, don't worry. Probably nothing is the matter at all. They're just getting their bearings. And this guy looks like he's testing his wings in the wind a little bit. Getting ready. Oh, are you gonna go? Well, I'm not gonna force it. But when it's ready, hopefully it will go and help my garden. And however your garden grows, keep growing as a gardener. It's right there. Oh gosh. Tell me you got that.
I did.
Yes!